Was Caleb and Joshua, were they discouraged? Okay, what did they say? That we are what? Well able. Okay, but you remember that Joshua and Caleb, they are the two spies that wholly follow the Lord. They wholly follow the Lord. They said that every time that Moses went up to the mountain for 40 days and all of these times in the tabernacle when the glory of the Lord came down and just filled the place, that Joshua was the one that was always accompanied. Moses, he was the commander of the host of Israel. They were the only two that entered the promised land, right? Only two of that generation. Everybody else died in the wilderness. So it does pay to endure hardness as a good soldier, does it? Does it? Okay. And remember, Jeremiah prophesied for a whole lot of years, probably 40 years. How many converts did he get? I don't think that he had any converts. But he kept crying. One time he gave up. And he said, amen, he just can't withhold the word because it was just like what? Fire. Should have been my bone. So, yeah, Noah preached 120 years. Nobody was saved except for his family. So we don't want to look at the frustration and the discouragement and the monumental task that we are, that lies before us. Amen. We just want to, amen, be sure, be convinced that we are doing the things that God has what commanded us to do. Amen. And sometimes we think that we are not successful until we get so many. We have a certain degree of success. But sometimes the things that God works in us, when we do things, when we go through things like that, the Bible says God's strength is made what perfect in our weakness. Amen. Our limitations. God's strength is made perfect. When you go through the hardest battles, that's the thing that cause you to be at your best and become more effective. Sometimes it might not be, it seems like you're going to be effective maybe here at Northside, amen, but sometimes you'll shine, amen, when God began to work with you, amen, in other places, amen. But all things will do work together for what? For good. To them that what? Love the Lord, and to them who are what? The call according to his what? Purpose. Amen. Also, it was after they took us over to, showed us kind of around, they took us over to a unit where just senior citizens, and I was really amazed. They said that we got all of these units here, we got all of these senior citizens here, and there's nobody coming in at all to minister to them. He said they would love if anybody would come and pick them up, took them to a movie, came in and showed a movie, came in and sang to them, came in and read a scripture to them, came in and had a service. See, things like that, many times people don't see any profit in dealing with people like that, because many times, you know, I guess the best you could expect locally is maybe you could pick up some of them and fill some of these pews, which would be a good thing. That would be a good thing. That would encourage somebody. Amen. If we had about four or five pews of older people in this church. Amen. And but I just couldn't believe that a place that nice, and they had activity rooms, they had sitting rooms. I mean, it's the state of the hospital, state of art. I mean, it's the, it's a perfect place. If Irene went to just take some lemonade, fix some lemonade and serve cookies, she would probably have a whole bunch of women that she could just talk to and just love on. She wanted to do a lesson. Want to have a tea party. And then she could leave feeling what? Real good. That's one thing about ministering to people. You do get a good feeling out of here. Oh, praise the Lord. So I think, you know, Sister Jackson even mentioned this to me. I was talking to her one day. She said that I was mentioning a prison ministry. I said, this year maybe it would be good for us to even pursue a prison ministry. And we could go whatever facility that probably would be open to us. We could go there and minister periodically. I know that her church has that. And she said that we already got one. She said that I would be glad. The problem we have, we don't have nobody to want to go. So she said that that ministry, I can make that available right now. Yes. I think that there are opportunities to give testimonies. You don't have to be a licensed preacher, ordained elder. Sometimes testimonies work perfectly in places like that. Testimonies of healing, testimonies of deliverance. All types of things can be done. If you got a singing ministry, a ministry of exhorting, ministry of prayer, how many believe that if you went through a senior citizen facility that probably you would get a lot of takers if all you had to offer was prayer. I think prayer is a great thing. Suppose you were able to go from room to room and just pray for this one and pray for that one. Is that a good ministry? Amen. I guarantee you it will change the way you pray. If I could get something that just take me a little higher in prayer. How many understand what I'm saying? If it would just take me a little higher in prayer, amen. If it would just give me a little bit more what? Burden, amen. And burden and yearning for the lost. If it would just take me higher. So that's the thing. You don't want to overrule. I mean, just to discount things like this, because there are things like this. Now, personally, I'm going to show you how I feel, tell you how I feel. If I had the opportunity to go into that facility just to pray and just maybe share scripture with them, I would do that. You know, it's not everybody's ministry, but I have that kind of ministry. I like that kind of ministry. If I could gather 10 or 15 together and even teach a Bible lesson, I would do that. And, they might would even come and hear me sing. Oh, praise God. Because after all, it's not what always the sound of the voice. It's what? It's the anointing. It's the anointing that breaks the yoke. Especially if you get, amen, praise God, locked into a spirit song.
Yeah.
But the bottom line, I just want to do something different, and I just don't want to come here and teach and preach to y'all. Amen. And sometimes y'all can, you know, take it or leave it, because we're not actively involved. See, if you're not actively involved, what I say many times don't mean nothing, because you are oversaturated. You know, you all hear so much, and we just need to sometimes what? Let it, get it, get some of it out. And then he said that we could come over and pick up a load of them. He said they don't ever go. They want to go somewhere. But I'm going back to Sister Irene. That's good, Sister Irene, is that you never know what anointing you would operate in when you go to places like that and just work with people. Your anointing will just grow. And then one day, God will open up some doors where you can be the star, superstar. I know. but the doors will be open at some point for you to minister to places where, amen, that experience will count big time for you. And that's what I want to, you know, I just don't want to just go through this year, because it's going to hinder my prayer if we just sit here and don't use what we have. I guarantee you, my prayer won't go no higher if I don't get out of here. This time next year, I'll be praying at the same level. Amen. Praise God. All right, Sister Shirley Brown was off here one morning. Boy, she prayed up a storm right underneath. They just prayed. Ooh, man. I just went back down the back seat and just laid down. I said, they don't need me. Boy, that was so good. And all of that anointing, boy, we got anointing to help 1,000 folk. Easy, Sister Shirley. Oh, Jesus. And after you begin to share with them, then God is going to really begin to open the eyes of your understanding. I mean, things just going to flow. Do this, do that. And I tell you, I will jump at any opportunity to go anywhere and minister to people that can't benefit me. In other words, they won't have no offerings. They're not someone that can work in the church, you know, without any kind of thought of reaping against some kind of what benefit from them. I would gladly go and just what? Sow into their lives. And I guarantee you, God will make it up to me. Amen. How many can say amen? And the thing I want to just share with you.
When do we
want to
start?
Amen. Well, tonight I'm just getting a feel, because I ain't going to go out there and open up this ministry by myself. So I got to get some input. Okay. I can talk to him probably before this week is over, so that we will talk to the congregation. And we got at least one. Okay, Brother Travis said y'all talked about it last night, so I guess we got the brothers. already committed. And Sister Irene and the Lord just showed me her. All right. The Lord showed me that. Yes, okay. I just need to get with him. And then we can sit down and begin. I could have that by Saturday. And then we could make that part of our agenda for evangelism. Saturday, I can have that, I believe, nailed down by then. Amen. So that will be the beginning of a unique ministry. And I believe that as we pray, God will give us creative ideas how we can what really help those people. Amen. If we want to have a dinner, invite 10 or 15 over on Sunday, they can be in church sometime. Amen. So whoever wants to coordinate that, we just have to be creative. And whatever the Spirit leads, then we come into agreement. And then we will go on and do that which the Spirit is leading us to do. All right. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, I want to just say this. Jesus, the secret of his success, because how many know that Jesus had a lot of his challenges were challenges, for instance, like the miracles and the signs, and how many remember the Gadarene demoniac? Jesus had some, he dealt with some hard stuff, some difficult situation. And so in order for us to be able to deal with things which seems impossible to all of us, one remedy is in unity there is strength, right? Amen. One person, Sister Irene, might not be able to cast out a devil, but when three people come together, there's a whole lot more power generated. Man, one can chase in a what? Thousand, but two can put what? So if we just stick with the word, if we're not able, then what? We can band together and go as a unit. In unity there is what? Strength. Amen. So I believe that we can do all things through Christ which strengthens us. So the key thing is that we have to totally trust and depend on God for his anointing and power. Okay, y'all hear me? We have to what? Totally trust and depend upon God for his anointing and power. And I interpret that to mean you go about that just like Jesus went about it. Jesus prayed with people, his disciples, is that right? Prayed alone, right? Right? And every move, even before he chose his disciples, he prayed. Amen. So I'm going to tell you, there's a lot of strength in praying together. Amen. I'm telling you, I wouldn't be nearly where I am, the little progress we've made in prayer. I wouldn't be nearly there if it hadn't been for you that's committed to prayer. I draw my strength from y'all. Y'all draw strength from me, each other. Amen. That's how you build yourself up. Amen. We have to what? Have the help of each other. And when you're pursuing things like this, it's very important for all of us what to come together. And that might motivate us to be a little bit more what diligent and committed to come into prayer. Amen. I think that if we said every month we're going to have morning prayer. Once a month we're going to have Friday night prayer. Pray for 3 hours. I believe that we'll have a lot more motivation then. If you know that your success is contingent upon what? Amen. Praying and seeking God. Amen. Now let me just bring this. John 6:38. This is under B on page 31. For I came down from heaven not to do mine own will, but the will of him that sent me. That should be the foremost thing in our heart. And John 8:28, I'm just reading these scriptures, all of them are lined up. I do nothing of myself, I do always these things that please him. I do nothing of myself. Amen. So the way that I approach this in the morning times as I pray, I say, Lord, you're the vine, I'm the branch. I'm just one of the branches. And I can do nothing of myself. Amen. Without you, I can do nothing. That expresses to him that I'm totally what? Dependent upon him to what? To do the works through me. Amen. And as you begin to confess that, as you begin to acknowledge that every good and every perfect gift is what? From above, from the Father of lights. You know, when you really begin to acknowledge these truths, then these truths will begin to become a reality to you. The next scripture says, the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the work. Amen. I'm going to, you know, what I envision is, you know, I'm a dreamer. And this week I said, I'm just going to say this. I don't care whether people like it or not. This scripture was really quickened to me. The Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. I said, I'm going to get the burden and the responsibility off of me, and I'm going to lay it on who? On the Lord. Yeah. But it's hard trying to do stuff, trying to make these miracles happen. Signs and wonders shall follow them that believe in my name, cast out devils. Amen. Sometimes we feel that we got to do that. I don't believe I can cast out a devil. I don't believe I got the power. Well, your sufficiency is not of yourself. It's the Father in me that dwells in me. He doeth the works. Amen. How many believe we can get that through our head and in our heart? The Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. Does that express complete dependency and trust in God? The Father that dwells in you. You acknowledge that God is in you. And some people think of God as being what? Up in heaven. Only. But it's God that's in us that's working the will and the ability to do his will in us. The Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. I want you to say, see if you can fix your mouth to say that. The Father that what? Okay, somebody tell me, what do you think that might work in you? What will that do if you said that enough? Anybody? Please help me. I need your help. If you said that enough, the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. Get the back. So you're not working alone, are you?
Nope.
We're workers together with him. Ooh, glory. Well, that ought to destroy some fear. And I was talking with a person out of town a couple of days ago, and I was sharing with them exactly kind of the things that we are dealing with, even the scriptures on God's compassion, you know, how God is full of eager yearning. And I just say, if you would just program. This person was facing something that she had to function in front of a group without fear so that she could articulate the things that they were questioning her about. She had to do it without fear. So I gave her all of the scriptures, just like I'm sharing with you. It's the Father that's in me doing the works. Amen. It's God's good pleasure to give me the kingdom. Kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's righteousness, peace, 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 peace. You notice that peace in the Holy Ghost. Today she called me back long distance, she said. Amen. It worked. I didn't have a bit of fear. Amen. Hallelujah. careful for nothing, but in all things by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. She said that became a reality. It pays to program the word of God into your life. Amen. The Father that dwelleth in me. But that makes you feel like God, the Father, is dwelling in me. Greater is he that is what? In me. Than my circumstance. Than my situation. Than whatever I'm facing. Amen. He doeth the work. Well, that's a good way to just let go and just cast all of the burden and responsibility and my inability, my the lack of know-how, my lack of my back experience. You know, I can't measure up. Amen. The Father doeth the works. Amen. I wish that was quickened to your hearts. Amen. Someone would rise up and you would say, I can do all things through. Now, I got all kind of little gadgets. Books and things. I got all kinds of stuff, but everything I need to perk me up, sister, I got it in place somewhere. And here's what it will really steer you up. My authority in Christ. The part of it that really stirs me up, and this is the thing that you need if we are preparing to pursue things that we have just discussed. It says, my authority in Christ. Okay, well, let me just back up. My union with Christ gives me and every believer the unique privilege of reigning with Christ, sharing in his authority and becoming workers together with him. My authority in Christ is not of myself, nor is it based on my might or my ability. It's not contingent upon how I feel, what I know, or what I think. It's based on God's power and might that backs me and the forces of heaven which stands behind me. My assurance and confidence is this regard, in this regard, comes from 2 Corinthians 3:4-6. This, my assurance and confidence in this regard comes from 2 Corinthians 3:4-6. This is what it says. And such trust have we through Christ to God, that we are sufficient, of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves. But our sufficiency is of God, who also hath made us able ministers of the new covenant, New Testament, not of the letter, but of the Spirit. The word of God is my battle axe and stronghold. I cannot fail. I can face the enemy without fear or hesitancy, being assured of victory in every battle I encounter and in every circumstance I confront. My Father says to me, see, this is God dwelling in you, fear thou not, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Watch this, this is the last thing I'm going to read. Even the weakest and the least member of the body of Christ has just as much power over Satan as anyone else, since his power is not of himself anyway. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Amen. So I say, I am strong in the Lord and in the power which comes from his might. Amen. Praise God. That was in my authority in Christ's confession. And I think that that is a perfect confession to focus on if you really want to move into a realm where our sufficiency is not of ourselves. Amen. God is working in me, and it's him that's doing the works. Amen. You can be confident then. You say, well, I ain't got to muster up all this power. I ain't got to know everything about in the Bible. I ain't got to know 50 scriptures. God's dwelling in me, and he's the one that's going to what? Amen. Who's the one that wants us to do the works anyway? Who's the one that told us what to do? So the responsibility is not ours. The battle is not ours. The battle is what? Is the Lord. Amen. That's the reason why Jesus said that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. No, he said that I cast out devils by the Spirit of God. That's how Jesus handled that. He complete, I cast out devils by what? The Spirit of God. Amen. All right, so whatever Jesus said and these expressions that we see all through the Bible, I think it's a good practice for us to begin to affirm them and to come into agreement with them, amen, and build that life and power and confidence and faith into our hearts, and then we can be bold, amen. Remember, boldness was one of the components that we see throughout the book of Acts. That's the reason why they were so effective, because they were what? When they saw the boldness of Peter, James, and John. Amen. Praise God. That's the thing that make you bold. Affirming what God says and what? And praying. Amen. In the Holy Ghost. Amen. Let's all say praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. Let's all, well, we've already prayed. Let's all stand. We're ready to go. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'm just waiting, Sister Denise, until we can get everybody in place, everybody doing what they're supposed to be doing. Amen. And I believe that we're going to see a difference in the atmosphere, in the environment in this church. And we're going to see a lot more zeal and fervor in prayer as we begin, amen, to come together more to pray, amen, for God's directions and God's approval on the things that he's leading us to do. Amen. Let's say amen. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy, to the only wise God, my Savior, be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody said, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. All right, we only got two more days.